up. We're not quite halfway, but this is when the show really starts kicking into another gear. A bunch of new faces up front now because of the pit strategy shuffle. You got a couple of veterans, a couple new guys, and got 50 laps to go or so.
Yeah, another interesting run is Parker Kligerman. We always see it, Vince. We talked about it in qualifying. He barely eked into the race. He was the slowest truck to qualify on time, and now he finds himself racing inside the top 10. So Kligerman's we said if he'd get in the race, he could win this race, and he's proven that we were right.
How about Colby Howard out front leading the way with John Hunter Nemechek right on his bumper, Zane Smith there in third, and Derek Krause fourth.
And earlier, you mentioned that they can't lock bumpers. They can't do the tandem drafting. It's still a judgment call on NASCAR's side of it, but when the leader drags the brake to the guy behind him, that initiates that to happen. If you do it too long, that's when they're going to make a call.
More on Colby Howard with Jamie.
How about it? His very first start here at Daytona leading this field. His spotter, Brandon Lyons, is tucking in third. He said, listen, we've already learned so much here tonight. Just stay low. You're going to get big pushes behind you. There's a really strong touch back there. Stay calm. We're going to finish as strong as we can, but don't forget what your goal is, and that's to make the playoffs at the end of the season.
Wow, that's a great statement by that young racer out of South Carolina. Three starts last year, two of them he finished inside the top 15. Turned some heads. People are saying this kid's got some talent. And now look at him here at Daytona leading the field.
A long single line. First truck up top is the 88 of Matt Crafton.
He's just on the outside of Thad Moffitt. And that number 43, Richard Petty, throwback scheme. You know why he has that Richard Petty scheme, right, Ben?
Well, that's Grandpa, right? Got on our grandpa.
Oh, trouble there for Chandler Smith.
Yeah, did he choose to just bail out? He's going to go back there and ride for a little bit?
That's pretty impressive what Moffitt has done. He got a lap down early, rebounded, and now racing up toward the top 10. There's that beautiful number 43.
Boy, that is a good-looking truck, too.
It's a throwback to Richard Petty's 1992 last season scheme. And there you can get a good look at the number 43. That brings back a lot of great memories for me and a lot of race fans, I'm sure.
It's got to be the most iconic and easiest resemblance of our sport.
Yeah, the free pass, the first stage, and he has worked himself all the way up inside the top 15, Jamie.
And we're going to see Thad Moffitt out in these truck races 12 to 15 times this year. It's something he's really looking forward to. He said, you know, think about the Petty name and everything that my family's been able to prove in racing. Nobody's really done anything here in the truck series. Adam Petty did two or three races years ago. He's looking to make a name for himself here in the truck series, Josh.
And speaking of making a name for themselves, Zane Smith up from 18th to 2nd. His first year in the 38 truck with front row after the championship last year, where he finished runner-up for the second year in a row. He was so dejected going into the offseason, not knowing where he would be after leaving GMS. Well, he's got that call from front row, and now he's out to prove that they made the right call. He's super excited to be with such a tight-knit team, guys.
Yeah, Chris Lawson, the crew chief there. Bob Jenkins, the owner at front row, super excited about their Truck Series program. And only five full-time.